What the hell is going on? Where's our air support? Get those forward guns going. Why aren't those rear batteries firing? Somebody get General Wilson on the horn!
Colonel Fury.
Doom, I'll have your head for this.
I have little time for your petty threats, Colonel. Surrender your ship now, or I shall destroy it.
Not on my watch.
This is a priority alert to all metahumans. UNN Alpha requests immediate assistance.
Thor, take care of those gunships! Spider-Man, draw them towards the stern!
Sure thing. I just love being a target.
Wolverine, you go it,
Boy Scout. I don't take orders from you.
Machine? How dare you strike the son of Odin?
Show off. Excuse me, is this the ferry to Staten Island? Use some help. That dude scares me.
Girls looking at. Why is he always late?
Hello, team. Welcome to Stark Tower, my pride and joy. It's 40 stories of heaven on earth.
Huh. It's amazing what you can do with just a few billion dollars.
We are now a team?
Yes. I've been empowered by SHIELD to create a task force to stop the Masters of Evil. But the helicarrier was so badly damaged that it can't be used as a headquarters. Fortunately, Tony is willing to let us stay here for the duration. It has all the facilities we'll require.
Believe me, it's no problem at all. And I called in a few old friends to help us out. Feel free to walk around and meet them.
I'd suggest you meet Hank Pym first, since he's in charge of equipment. The Vision is here as our information officer.
Great. We got a computer to talk to the computers for us.
When you're ready to go on a mission, talk to Wyatt Wingfoot. He'll take you there in one of my Quinjets.
Speaking of that, what is our next mission, Colonel?
I recently received a radio transmission from Dum Dum Dugan requesting that I come to the Omega base. But there was something questionable in his message.
You think it might be a trap?
Maybe. I can't be sure. For more information, talk to the Black Widow. We're close to the landing zone, so I'll be brief. Dum Dum Dugan recently sent a suspicious radio message requesting I meet him at the Omega base for a report on the latest Super Soldier Serum.
What's so suspicious about that?
Dr. Banner was to give the report. The only thing is, Banner has been working on the Gamma Bomb project, not the Super Soldier Serum. Dugan would never make a mistake like that. Something's up.
What is the Omega base?
It's a mobile lab that's over 5 stories tall. We use it for field testing experiments.
Oh, SHIELD's the greatest! Flying aircraft carriers, office buildings on wheels. Please tell me you've got a tunnel that runs from New York to Tokyo.
Spider-Man, this is serious. Colonel, is there anything on board the Omega that would be considered dangerous?
If the contents of that vehicle were to fall into the wrong hands, it would be disastrous for all mankind.
Exactly what are you developing that could threaten the entire planet?
That's classified.
So it's all right for us to save the vehicle. We just can't know what's going on there.
Correct. Now, if I may continue, the team's mission will be to sneak on board the Omega and locate Dugan. He should be able to bring you up to speed on the situation. Any questions? All right, good luck.
Listen up, people. We've been sent here to investigate a situation in Atlantis.
What kind of situation we talking about here, Cap?
An hour ago, Namorita sent a message saying a riot's taking place. A crowd broke into the throne room of Atlantis and dragged Namor off his throne.
Why would the Atlanteans riot? They love Namor.
I don't know. Namorita had to stop transmitting before she could give any details.
How are we to handle a mission in the undersea conditions of Atlantis?
There's nanotechnology at this outpost that will let us breathe and move normally through the water. I want to remind you, the Atlanteans aren't exactly big fans of us surface dwellers.
What if they become violent?
Defend yourselves. We have to help Namor any way we can. He's a valuable ally. That's it. Let's be careful out there.
Loki, are you certain your ploy in Atlantis worked?
My good doctor, how could you doubt the god of mischief? My performance as Mandarin was flawless. Rest assured, the heroes will travel to the Valley of Spirits.
I wonder who will be the worse for this confrontation, the heroes or Mandarin?
It matters not, so long as one of them pays the ultimate price.
The traitorous Mandarin will most likely meet his demise, but not without destroying several of Fury's lackeys first.
Indeed. I would find it most enjoyable if my dear brother Thor were to fall in battle, long as he been a thorn in my side. Oh, don't look so sad, Enchantress. When our ultimate plan is realized, you will find others more worthy of your attention than Thor.
I should hope so, Loki. Still, it saddens me that Thor must die. He is truly a god to be admired.
That pompous fool's overdeveloped physique is nothing compared to my conniving intellect. Now, I have longed to crush his self-righteous countenance beneath my booted heel.
Silence! All of you. My scanners show the heroes are in the Valley of Spirits. We have set the stage. And the players have arrived. Now, let us watch and see who will survive this tale of deception.
He's awake! Shield the castle! Now!
Baron Mordo, I trust all is in order. Our guests will be arriving soon, and I would hate to be ill-prepared.
You can rest assured. I have taken all the necessary steps.
Ha! An infant could have cast better spells. The heroes have detected your magic and suspect something is afoot.
They cannot possibly know the true meaning of the enchantments. I'd stake my life on it.
Be careful what you wager.
Loki, leave the good Baron alone. What does it matter if the heroes suspect? They will still be ensnared by the trap.
For his sake, they'd best be. I'm taking a grave risk being associated with the Masters of Evil.
Make no mistake, my friend. We all stand to lose much if we fail. Which is why I'm certain Baron Mordo will achieve success. But I would warn you, Baron. My faith only goes so far. Failure will not be tolerated, and the penalty will be most unpleasant. What of the mutant amplifier we stole from the Omega base? Does it work?
Yes. Even better than I dare hope. But time is now a factor in our plans.
Why is that?
The mutant amplifier is quite destructive. If we do not move swiftly, the X-Man we kidnapped will die.
You surprise me, Dr. Doom. Why do you care for the health of the mutant?
I don't. An early death would hinder our plans. But make no mistake, death for the X-Man is inevitable.
Team, this next mission takes you to Mephisto's realm. It's an alternate dimension that's filled with fire and brimstone.
Gah! Why can't we ever be sent to an alternate dimension filled with lonely supermodels?
Because we're going to save Nightcrawler. You got a problem with that?
Nope. Sorry. I'll just be quiet now.
Best news I heard all day.
Why is Nightcrawler in Mephisto's realm?
Dr. Doom somehow forced him to teleport a group of them to that dimension.
How is that possible? Nightcrawler's abilities were never that strong.
They used a device known as a mutant amplifier. It magnified his powers far beyond the norm.
What's this amplifier doing to Kurt?
We estimate it's overdriven his powers to the point that it's causing physical damage. You have to move fast, or it'll kill him.
Do you know why the Masters of Evil are going to this dimension?
No. Any knowledge you gain would be helpful. So far, we've been completely in the dark as to what Doom is up to.
But Kurt comes first. We ain't risking his life. You got it, bub.
I understand, Wolverine. Nightcrawler's safety is the number one priority. So get moving.
Ho, brave warriors of Asgard! I've come to pay my respects to Odin!
Loki.
And of course, I brought presents. Behold, my tribute to the All-Father. The day of reckoning has arrived! Long have I been denied my rightful place. But now, I have the power to take it! Odin's throne will be mine!
My friends, these are indeed dark times. The Masters of Evil have overwhelmed the army of Asgard, and the only path for reinforcements has been closed off to us, the Bifrost Bridge.
Isn't that how your people travel back and forth between Earth and Asgard?
Aye. A great many warriors would return, if only the path were open.
How did Doom manage to block off Bifrost?
The gate at the end closest to Earth has been closed and barred. It can only be opened from our side. But I would warn you, the Wrecking Crew is guarding the gate.
The Wrecking Crew? Ooh, pardon me for not being scared.
I gotta agree with Webhead here. How bad can these jokers be?
The Wrecking Crew is not to be taken lightly. They are humans who were mistakenly granted the powers of one of my people. More than once, they have sorely tested my powers.
They almost beat you? Then we'd better be on our guard.
They are formidable opponents, but that is not all. Loki has struck a bargain with Hela, the goddess of death. Her minions will also seek to stop us.
So we're fighting gods and the undead. Right. Anyone else nervous about our odds here?
We must succeed. Without those additional forces, there is little hope for Asgard.
Not to worry, Thor. We'll get those gates open.
I thank you, my friends. Let us battle on to victory.
Ha ha! It was more wondrous than my wildest of dreams. How I wish I could forever relive the fall of Asgard.
It was so amusing to watch the oafish knaves as they fought in defense of their beloved city.
But one by one, they realized that all was lost. Heimdall, Tyr, and even the mighty Balder have tasted the bitter dregs of defeat. Now I, Loki, am the true Lord and Master of Asgard. And all those who have dared to mock me are in chains, beaten, and hopeless.
Need I remind you, Loki, that your brother Thor still remains free?
Your fascination with the God of Thunder grows tiresome, Enchantress.
But has he not proven himself your better time and time again?
Careful. That beauteous face will gain you only so much of my mercy.
But she does bring a valid point to light. Thor will likely attempt to liberate the fallen warriors.
Think you that I would not be prepared? Traps aplenty wait for those who would dare to free my prisoners.
Traps that even they cannot overcome?
You underestimate me, Doom. After all, am I not the god of mischief? My brother and his friends will most assuredly enter Asgard. But trust me when I say they will never leave.
The final phase of our plan is about to commence. The attack on the Omega base, the kidnapping of the X-Men, and our dealings with Mephisto have all led up to this moment. I would remind you that failure is not an option.
You worry too much, my good doctor. We are more than prepared to achieve our ultimate goal.
And you worry too little. How often have we all had victory firmly in our grasp, only to have it snatched away by the heroes?
You do realize, Baron Mordo, that the price of failure will be the wrath of Odin. Are you prepared for that?
No. No, I don't suppose I am.
None of us are. It would be a fate worse than death.
And that is why we must be absolutely certain we are willing to do what must be done for success.
Fear not, Dr. Doom. I am prepared for whatever challenges we meet.
As am I. Just knowing the rewards that await makes it all worthwhile.
Of that, you have no fear, Ultron. Everyone will get what's coming to them.
Am I dead? Why does heaven smell like a wet dog? Oh wait, never mind.
I am Uatu, the Watcher. I prevented your deaths, for you are needed to save this universe. Listen closely, mortals. Dr. Doom's unrestrained use of Odin's power will soon tear the fabric of reality beyond repair. I have broken my sacred vow to only observe so that I may give you this one chance to save your world.
Who can stand against the power of Odin? Even the gods of mighty Asgard have fallen.
Doom's power seems unlimited, but you must know a way to stop him.
Yes, there is a chance, but it will be difficult. First, you must obtain the Makran Crystal, a Shi'ar gem of fantastic power. Next, you must acquire another object of great power, and it will take all your strength and skill. You must face the World Eater known as Galactus.
You'll be traveling to the Shi'ar Empire for this next mission. It's located in a galaxy in another part of the universe. Once there, you'll need to lay hands on a shard of the Makran Crystal.
Will the Shi'ar be willing to part with it?
The crystal is very important to the Shi'ar, but we're good friends with their ruler, Lilandra. I don't think she'll mind giving it to us, especially once she learns how important it is in stopping Dr. Doom.
You X-Men are pretty well connected. You've even got buddies in other galaxies.
Xavier's the one who's close to Lilandra. They used to be good friends. Really good friends, if you catch my meaning.
Ooh, guess that means Lilandra's not gonna be some wrinkled old prune of a queen.
You can say that again, bub.
What is the Shi'ar Empire?
It's an ancient kingdom that spans entire galaxies and consists of thousands of different civilizations.
Are they peaceful?
They have had their periods of upheaval, usually due to struggles within the royal family. But for the most part, yes.
What exactly is this Makran crystal?
It houses a gateway into a universe filled with neutron stars. The power available there is beyond measure.
I can see how that would be useful in defeating Dr. Doom.
All right then. Get to Shi'ar and locate Lilandra as fast as you can. Once you've convinced her to give you the crystal, get back here pronto. Good luck. You're about to be sent to the homeworld of the Skrull. There you need to steal a device called the Muonic Inducer from Galactus, who is presently attacking the Skrull planet.
Why is Galactus at war with the Skrull?
He's not. Galactus is there to consume the planet.
Whoa! This dude eats planets? I gotta get a picture of that.
He doesn't really eat them. He has machines that convert the planet into energy he can absorb. One of those devices is the Muonic Inducer.
I wouldn't think old Galactus is gonna be too happy with us trying to steal one of his toys.
No, he won't be. Which is why I'd strongly advise against any confrontation with him. Galactus is one of the most powerful beings we've ever encountered.
That would explain why he feeds off entire planets. But how does he choose which worlds to consume?
He has a herald for that. A scout who determines which planet's next on the menu.
Well, at least we can count on the Skrull to help us out.
Not necessarily. The Skrull are a warlike people who've attacked the Earth several times before. They'll most likely see you as enemies.
Wonderful. So if Mr. Universe doesn't completely crush us, the Skrull will be happy to finish the job.
Yes. Is that a problem?
No. Just wanted to make sure what the teams are.
Well, good. Now get moving.
Much has transpired since you were last on Earth. Mankind did its best to defend itself against Doom. But even their greatest weapons were as nothing before Doom's power. The heroes of your world also tried to stop Doom and paid the ultimate price.
Going to be arriving at Doom's castle soon. Once there, you'll have to locate Doom and use the Makran crystal to steal his power.
You can bet your boots Doom ain't gonna let that go without a scrap.
Make no mistake, you're in for the fight of your lives, but it has to be done. As predicted, tears are developing in near-Earth space because of Doom's unbridled use of power. Pretty soon even Doom won't be able to stop it.
What will happen if the tears are left unchecked?
The universe will unravel in a matter of months. All life will cease to exist everywhere. Gone forever.
Wow, not to criticize, but this mission briefing is turning into a real downer.
I don't know any other way to put it. Trillions of lives are depending on you to defeat Dr. Doom. Look, I know we've had our differences over the course of this little adventure, and I know you don't agree with the way I've done some things. But as the director of S.H.I.E.L.D., I can't ever afford to lose. And now you're in the same boat. You have to win this one.
Not to worry, Colonel. I am prepared.
Wolverine and I are certainly ready for anything.
You got that right.
Yeah, I've always wanted to fight someone with the powers of a god.
Don't worry, Colonel. We know what's riding on this. We won't fail.
I know you won't. Good luck. And watch yourselves.
You've accomplished nothing!
Doom!
Hogan! You can't be free!
Your wretched scheme is undone! And your black soul is mine!
No!
An eternity of suffering is the fate of those who challenge the gods!
You gotta thank your old man for me, Thor. Odin did one hell of a job reversing the damage Doom did to Earth.
Aye, but I believe he is presently occupied with Doom and my brother Loki.
Let's hope he's teaching them new kinds of pain. The world owes you a debt of gratitude it can never repay. But with the danger past, our task force must be disbanded.
You're a punk, Fury.
Listen, fellas. I don't care if you like me, but if a threat like this comes again, can S.H.I.E.L.D. count on your help?
The world can count on us, sir.
Such insignificant creatures. They dare steal from Galactus. For that, I will destroy their planet.
I ain't your boy, Stark.
Alright, that should do it. Won't be any Latverian air support bothering us on our way to Castle Doom now. We'll take it on foot and bring in Bravo Team once we hit Checkpoint 3.
On foot? You're kidding, right? Do you have any idea how little arch support I get in this outfit?
Put a sock in it, Webhead.
Ow, socks make it worse, actually.
All right, ladies, let's move, now! Bravo team, come in. Come in. Bravo, do you copy?
Nothing new to me so far. But Black Ops aren't really SOP for you boys, are they? How'd Fury get you?
Same way he got you two, I expect. Everyone owes that old warhorse favors. And he always calls them in sooner or later. Could be much worse than
come
this.
In.
Yeah, but don't you guys wonder, I mean, invading a foreign country? Like we're soldiers of fortune or something?
I've known Nick Fury a very long time, Spider-Man. We wouldn't be doing this without a good reason.
Aw, wringing your little hands over the poor Latvarians, huh? You think they'd do the same for you?
Colonel Fury, what do you have for us?
Mr. President, one of our ongoing investigations into supervillains recently had a major break. We've always been aware that many of these criminals who run around in high-tech armor were getting their materials from an underground figure, Phineas Mason, a.k.a. the Tinkerer. But what we didn't realize until recently is that the Tinkerer himself is being supported by someone outside the country, specifically Lucia von Bardas, elected Prime Minister of Latveria. As you know, the link to a foreign power makes this, by definition, international terrorism. The evidence is right here, sir. We're under attack. Trust me, they've earned what's coming to them. Great. Here we go again.
Hey, Fury, where's that Bravo team you've been trying to reach?
Communication's still jammed. Someone's gonna have to go round them up. And you just volunteered.
What? And leave all the fun to you girls? Bite me, Fury.
No time to argue, Shorty. Take Webbs with you. Locate Bravo team and find another way into that castle.
You heard the man, Webhead. Let's move.
Yeah, yeah.
Sheesh. Respect.
I'm here to make an example of you. This place is going down, along with your little operation. Should help deter anyone thinking along the same lines.
So much for your president's friendly words to me. Or does he even know you're here?
You've got a simple choice, Toots. Either come with us quietly, or die when we turn this place into a big pile of Latverian bricks.
You'll pay for this, Nicholas Fury. I promise you that. Take them!
Quiet around here lately. I suppose we should have known it was too good to last.
Miss Marvel has been investigating an international gun-running ring in the city. A lead identified this Roosevelt Island construction site as a front for their operations. And last night she reported discovering unexpected tunnels running beneath it. This morning she failed to check in.
Carol can definitely take care of herself, but we'll need to follow up on this just in case. Let's start by investigating those tunnels.
Manhattan continues to reel after tonight's devastating terror attack. Inside sources are indicating that the terrorists may have been from Latveria. Furthermore, they claim last night's attack was in direct retaliation for a secret, unsanctioned SHIELD assault on Castle Doom exactly 1 year ago. SHIELD Director Nicholas Fury, now wanted for questioning in connection with these claims, has disappeared. In his absence, Commander Maria Hill has been named Acting Director of SHIELD. Superheroes potentially linked to the Latverian mission have refused to comment, leaving the rest of us to wonder why this horrible tragedy had to happen.
You hear what they're saying about that mission in Latveria?
Color me shocked, Steve. I have suspected we weren't sanctioned.
You have suspected? Nice of you to say so at the time.
Given a choice between Fury and the government, who are you gonna trust?
Tough call.
That's why I didn't even ask you to make it.
So, thanks to you, all this is on our hands.
No, not on yours. The evidence is right here, sir. We're under attack.
Colonel Fury, since Dr. Doom's death, Lucia von Bardas has bent over backwards to mend the ties between America and Latveria. We got her elected. This year alone, we lent her country $72 million in aid.
Yes, sir. And it hurts to imagine what she's done with that money, knowing what we now know.
Thank you, Colonel.
I have a recommended response scenario for the situation.
That won't be necessary.
Sir, if I may, this situation is sure to escalate.
We have a pleasant relationship with Lucia. We'll handle things diplomatically.
I kept you in the dark so that if something like this ever happened, your consciences would be clear. It's on me, and I'm taking the fall for this one.
You got that right.
Damn it, Stark. You think
these things grow on trees?
I'm sure you've got plenty of backups, old man. You always do.
Enjoy your exile, Fury. Wherever you are. We'll just stay here and keep picking up the pieces.
Our worst fears seem to be coming to pass. Congress is debating a new bill, the Superhuman Registration Act. It would require all heroes to register with the government, whether they want to or not.
Which would mean the politicians get to tell us who the bad guys are. We need to make sure this thing doesn't happen.
To that end, we're heading down to Washington. I've been offered a chance to testify before a congressional subcommittee.
And I'm going to rally the people down there. We need to get a grassroots resistance movement going before the SRA can gain any momentum.
We want you to come along in case there's any trouble. We've got a Quinjet waiting to fly us down there. Let's go. We're coming up on DC, team, but the situation has radically changed during our flight, and not for the better. The city just came under attack by an unknown terrorist force. We're going to coordinate defense efforts with SHIELD. Buckle up, and be ready for anything.
And so, to answer your question, Mr. Senator, in spite of these recent events, I don't believe forcing superheroes to register with the government is the answer. This law would split the hero community right down the middle, with consequences I'm not sure any of us want to ponder.
Hey, Mr. Stark! Mr. Stark, over here!
Was that really your best shot?
Sneaking around doesn't become you, Steve.
Maybe I'll need the practice. Maybe we all will.
Don't be so melodramatic. This whole thing would affect you least of all. You're already deputized.
You almost sound like you agree with them. This Registration Act would tear down everything we've done, destroy a century-old tradition of...
I'm trying to save it, Steve. As much of it as I can, anyway. Don't you see where this is headed? All it's going to take is one more slip-up by anyone in a cape, and we'll be lucky if registration is the worst they do. They could just turn us all into criminals, hunt us all down.
No, they won't, Tony. Not in my country.
Now return to our special live episode of The New Warriors, coming to you straight from Stamford, Connecticut, where the Warriors have just been spotted by their supervillain quarry. Looks like it's on.
I've got Cold Heart, you guys. Hey, somebody snag Nitro. He's rabbiting.
Don't worry, Speedball. I'm on him. On your feet, Nitro. And don't bother trying any of your stupid exploding tricks.
Oh, baby, don't you even know? You're playing with the big boys now.
Reports now coming in from Stamford, Connecticut indicate a massive explosion in a residential neighborhood.
Just over 12 hours ago now, and preliminary casualties are said to be over 600.
In Washington, rumblings on whether superhero reform should be brought to the
table. Following last week's devastating explosion, Congress has rushed through passage of the Superhuman Registration Act, with the president expected to sign it.
This is just completely insane, Hill. I won't do it.
I'm sorry. Was it not clear I was giving you an order?
You're asking me to arrest people who risk their lives for this country every day.
No, I'm ordering you to obey the will of the American people, Captain. Either you help us bring them in, or we'll bring you in.
Weapons down, gentlemen. Or I...
Trank darts, now! Take him down! Take him down!
Keep us moving, son, if you want to stay conscious.
You idiot. We were trying to save lives.
Of all the people to go underground, Captain America. Now every superhero who disagrees with the act suddenly has a leader. Maybe we should hold off until...
That won't be necessary, Mr. President. Registration can go forward as planned. We'll take care of Captain America.
How many trapped workers did the radio say?
Over 300. But something's weird. I'm not getting anything over my infonet. No panic signals, nothing.
What's wrong, Cable?
Cloak, get us out of here. It's a trap.
Of course it's a trap. How else were we going to get you all in one place? Skybird 1, is the area fully cordoned?
Roger, perimeter sealed.
No one's leaving the zone without our say-so.
Copy that. Stand by.
Stand by? You and S.H.I.E.L.D. going soft, Tony.
We didn't come here to arrest you, Cap. I talked S.H.I.E.L.D. into offering all of you a chance at amnesty.
You mean surrender? Thanks, but I think I'd rather take my chances.
Cap, please. You know how hard I tried to fight this. But that was before Stamford. The public doesn't want secret identities anymore. Registration is the only way to make them feel safe when we're around. Just give me a chance to tell you our plans for my 21st century overhaul.
You've got 5 minutes.
That's all I'll need. What the hell?
Not all. Neither side's getting too specific, but a good number of those heroes got pretty badly hurt in the explosions, including yourselves. No one saw what those mind-controlled freaks were trying to do, or that we tried to stop them. So it was up to me to save you.
All right, listen up.
Tinkerer here has been trying to figure out who might be pulling the strings of S.H.I.E.L.D.'s nanite criminals when no one's looking.
Since I had some involvement in the original nanotechnology S.H.I.E.L.D. has converted for their use, I was optimistic that I could puzzle out the situation with the data already available. However, that has not proven to be the case. I have nothing more than conjecture at this point. In order to determine what's really happening, I will need to view the networking logs for S.H.I.E.L.D.'s nanite control grid. Unfortunately, their signal is highly encrypted. It could take years to break their code and directly access their servers.
But we don't have time for that, obviously. The shorter and quicker routes to physically transmit that data directly from their servers, which we've discovered are located in Rikers Island Penitentiary. So that's where you're headed. Now don't worry. I know trying to bust into that place on your own would be near impossible, since it also contains the portal to Stark's negative zone prison. But we got information that Captain America and his forces are about to stage a prison break to release their buddies from the negative zone. They'll have to smash through Rikers to get there. We'll take advantage by having you piggyback on their incursion. While they're driving toward the portal, you follow in their wake and get that data sent to us. Then we can figure out who the hell's grabbing control of these psychos and why. We got the transmission, and Tinkerer's done a quick analysis on the data. It doesn't look good.
We were concerned that an unknown megalomaniac might be overriding S.H.I.E.L.D.'s nanite control signals with intentions unknown. However, the truth is much stranger and potentially much more troubling. There is no secret mastermind pulling the strings of these criminals. The network that links their minds has become large and complex enough to emerge as its own intelligence. A neural net whose intellect grows each time they inject another host with the nanites.
The only reason this thing hasn't already spread like wildfire is because S.H.I.E.L.D. lets just a few of them out at a time.
Correct. If the entire group were released from lockdown, they could escape Prison 42 and quickly spread across the Earth like a techno plague. Everyone would eventually become part of its collective consciousness.
We already saw they could override S.H.I.E.L.D. control. Wouldn't there be any way to stop them?
To determine that, I would need a pure, untainted sample of the nanite material. One that hasn't yet been injected into a host.
Okay, they must have some of that in their negative zone jailhouse. And we won't get a better chance to head in there and grab some of that stuff than right now, while the heroes are still beating the crap out of each other. I'm gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Sit tight till I arrive to help you out.
We'll never reach the jail cells at this rate.
Are those the conduits we saw on the schematics?
Yeah. The only exposed power cables for both the main systems and the backups.
Those get cut, and all the cells open up, including S.H.I.E.L.D.'s remote control super criminals?
You got it. But the released prisoners might give S.H.I.E.L.D. more than they can handle, at least for a few minutes. Could help cover our escape.
No effect, Mr. Stark! The villains are completely out of control!
You don't say.
Looks like Fury was right about your nanite-injected slaves.
We had it under control until you busted in here and released them all.
Gentlemen, I suggest we focus on getting our people out of here alive.
You made it. Was Fury behind you?
Closed off from the other side.
What do you think it means? Did Fury detonate?
Step to one side, Captain. You and your friends here are under arrest.
For Pete's sake, Hill, these people need medical attention.
He's right. Lower your weapons and call in the medics.
No, Stark. I'm under direct orders from the President. The SRA dictates that these unregistered...
We're giving everyone temporary amnesty on my authority. At least until we figure out what just happened. If you have a problem with that, Commander Hill, you're going to have to take it up with all of us.
Get the medics down here.
So many lives apparently lost, and yet lost so that many more lives might be saved. We may not know the true fate of Nicholas Fury, but we do know he showed his willingness to sacrifice himself on behalf of us all. For him, and for the rest of the missing and presumed deceased, we ask Almighty God to watch over their souls. Amen.
In the span of just a few hours, the world has gone insane. The Nanite Collective's agents are swarming all over the globe, infecting key victims in an apparent bid to eliminate all serious resistance to their expansion.
Their movements seem methodical and well-coordinated. They must have used Prison 42's portal system to move this fast. Worse, time is on their side. If we can't stamp this out quickly, it will grow to encompass all of humanity.
In the face of this new threat, the Registration Act's been temporarily suspended to allow us to work together.
We're deploying teams around the world, but the most explosive situation right now is in the African nation of Wakanda, which has reported a massive incursion into their capital city. Ruled by our friend T'Challa, also known as the Black Panther, Wakanda is a highly advanced country blessed with the world's only deposits of vibranium.
Your knowledge of the Nanite Collective makes you the best team to send into this combat zone. Do whatever it takes to help Black Panther defeat these invaders and regain control of his country. The fall of Stark Tower was just the beginning. Over the past few weeks, the Fold has aggressively ramped up its campaign to take over all of humanity. Many of our closest friends and allies remain unaccounted for. We have to assume they've been taken into the Fold.
It's no coincidence either. The Fold's primary targets are clearly superhumans. And thanks to the acquisition of Fury and his decades of intel, they've been able to make serious inroads in expanding the Collective's power base. Fortunately, Fury's knowledge of Wakanda isn't comprehensive, which is why we've been using Black Panther's palace as our temporary base of operations.
Fold forces were unable to retrieve Venom and Green Goblin after you defeated them. Using the pure nanite samples your team obtained from Prison 42, we've been able to cure these two criminals of their infection.
Venom and Goblin both claim a strong desire to help us stop the Fold. They're not the most trustworthy of allies, but frankly, we can't afford to turn them away. With the Fold growing exponentially, infecting entire populations at a time, it's becoming obvious we can't win a war of attrition against them. Their network seems to be the key. If we could only find a way to disrupt it. Unfortunately, they've clearly been taking steps to make that all but impossible.
Our best minds are working hard to devise a strategy to defeat the Fold before it becomes unstoppable. We'll let you know if and when we come up with anything solid.
Analysis of Fold technology retrieved after the liberation of Wakanda has revealed details about the Collective and how it's spreading. We're now aware of massive repeater towers being erected at secret locations around the globe at an astonishing rate.
These heavily defended towers are clearly being built to extend the reach of their network. Like the Internet, their grid is adaptive and seems highly resistant to being completely shut down. So trying to destroy the towers would be an inefficient use of our time and resources.
However, we might still have an ace in the hole. Our nanite stasis signal should still function, if we could only broadcast it on their network. Their encryption makes that impossible to do from the outside. But if we were able to take control of one of their repeater towers and send the signal from there, it just might work.
We've identified only one tower that is central enough to reach the entire fold before they could react.
If we were able to infiltrate this enemy base and send the shutdown signal, all members of the fold would be paralyzed, allowing us to round them up and cure them of the nanite infection.
It sounds simple, but won't be easy. Iceland was one of the first countries to be completely overtaken by the Collective. However, this may be our only shot at defeating the Fold. If we fail here, we'll have revealed our only trump card, and they won't give us another chance once they figure out what we're up to. We'll get as close to the tower as we can without attracting their attention. From there, we'll have to fight through their defenses, make our way into the base, and send out that signal.
Over him any day.
So how are you feeling?
How's it look like I'm feeling?
Could be a lot worse, all things considered. Everyone else who was infected is pretty much recovered, but the stuff that Tinkerer put in you was 10 times.
Yeah, I know. But believe me, I know. Listen, guys, about all this,
You can stop there, Nick. There's plenty of blame to go around, on all sides.
And plenty of cleaning up yet to do.
Yeah, there is that. I know you'll put it right. Get things back to where they used to be.
I'm not sure things will ever be quite the same as they used to be.
No, but that doesn't mean they can't be good again.